In this video, we are going to look at how to create an assembly from polylines. Currently, I have an assembly here. I have assembly and I have sub-assembly part here. So I want to connect this kind of part to this assembly. Currently, this is created from polyline. It is a closed shape and it is created from polylines. So let us say I need to convert this to a sub-assembly. So before doing anything, currently if I select this object, you can see you have several grips here. So let us say I don't need this grip, so I will remove this vertex and make it a more better shape. Now you have few more corners here, this kind of shape. Now I am going to convert this to a sub-assembly and attach to this sub-assembly. So to do that, you need to go to Home tab and then go to Create Design Panel and go to Create Sub-Assembly from Polyline. So you click this option. Now it is asking select an entity. So you have to select these entities. So you have only one closed shape, so I will select that one. So you can give a name here. Then you have some other parameters. You can set the mid dot net distance. You can set the link creation. So you have to, you'll see there are multiple links here. So after clicking OK, it will erase the existing entities. That means it will erase this object and convert it completely to a sub-assembly. So if you want to retain the object, you have to uncheck this option. Now I will click OK. So you will see now it becomes a sub-assembly. But even though it becomes a sub-assembly, it does not have some important pack factors of a sub-assembly, such as codes and shapes. So currently you can see this is our origin. This is the place where our sub-assembly will be getting attached to another sub-assembly. So if you want to change this origin, you can use this option. If you want to change this origin to this point, you can move it here. So I change it up to this point. This is where I need it. So then you can add point codes for each options. Let us say I will add code here. So you have to go to add code. So you are, while you are selecting the sub-assembly, you can add codes. So I will add code. It will ask me where to add code. Where to add code. But before that, you have to enter the code. So you have codes. You can specify codes in these locations where you have grips. So first I will do this as top code and press enter. Then it is asking select a sub-assembly point, link or shapes to add that code. So I will select this link, so it will add the top code here. Let us say I need to add another top code to here. So I go to add code and my code is top. And I click OK and I will add it to here. Then if you in same way, you can add to the these two options as well for top codes. And at here I will add this as datum codes. So I will select this one and go to add code and select type the name as datum, because these are at the bottom, so we select this codes as datum and I press enter. Now I select this point and it will add a code. Again I add a datum code to the other side as well. So now you have add codes. So I will add two more codes here, top codes. So if you need to remove any code, you can remove the codes using this option. If you need to remove this code, you can use this option to remove that code. So I will add this top code here. Now instead of adding code, I added a link. This I added a top link. So if you want to add the top links, you still you can do that. Mistakenly I added a link actually instead of a code. So these are top links. So if you want to make them make other links to top links or bottom links, you can add them. So I will add a top code here as well. Top. And I will add the top code here as well. So if you like, you can add top links here and a datum link or a bottom link here and other links as you wish in these locations. And also you can add a shape from here. Add shape, then it is asking select sub assembly links to add the shape code. So you can select these sub assemblies to make a close area and click, so it will automatically add a shape. So if you want to remove that shape, you can use this option. So now we have created our sub assembly. Now we are going to attach it to this assembly, actually this sub assembly. So our attachment point is this one. So we click this sub assembly, then you have to use this option, add to assembly. Then it is asking where to add the assembly. So you have to select where you need to add that new sub assembly which is created with polylines into our generic assembly or a normal sub assembly. So I will click here, so it will attach to my sub assembly and make a normal assembly. So if you go to assembly properties, you will see now our sub assembly part is attached, but since it is a manually created one, it will not show any parameters. If you go here, it will show parameters, but here it will not show parameters because that is created from polylines. So I'll click cancel here. So you can now use this sub assembly or complete assembly in a corridor and get your result as you wish. So if you want a separate result or more precise results, you can change these links and codes and shapes. Actually you can't change the shape, but you can change these link codes and point codes to get more precise output from the corridor. So that is how to create a sub assembly from polyline.